Hey, what's up, everyone? Neil Cypher here, starting a bit of an impromptu project. This is what happens when you just got paid and a game on your wish list on Steam goes on sale. And it's a game I've been wanting to play for a while, and that is Cuphead. So, this is, again, a bit of an impromptu project. I am still working on Skylanders Giants. And I'm going to get off this title screen because I have heard this song so many times trying to get my headset to work. I'm going to turn down the volume here a little bit. Not that I don't like the nice little 30s era throwback song, whatever decade this goes back to, yeah, 1930. But I've heard this song so many times now, just trying to get my microphone to work. So I have played very little of Cuphead. I've actually seen very little of Cuphead. I've been trying to avoid watching videos on it. The only little bit of it this I have played was I tried one of the bosses at a local game store where they had it on display. I went there for a retro gaming event not too long ago, and like I said, on display they had Cuphead up on the screen, so I tried out one of the bosses. So I'm not necessarily going into the game 100% blind. I would say about 99.9% blind. See, once upon a time, in a magical place called Inkwell Isle, there were two brothers named Cuphead and Mugman. Sounds like a Mega Man boss. They lived without a care under the watchful eye of the wise elder Kettle. Because cup-related puns. One day, the two boys wandered far from home and, despite the elder Kettle's many warnings, ended up on the wrong side of the tracks and entered the Devil's Casino. As you do. Inside, Cuphead and Mugman soon found themselves on a winning streak at the craps table. "Hot dog!" exclaimed King Dice, the casino's sleazy manager. "These fellas can't lose." "Nice run, boys," laughed the newcomer. The brothers gasped. It was the casino's owner, the devil himself. "Now how about we raise the stakes?" he suggested with a toothy grin. "Win one more roll and all the loot in my casino is yours," the devil boomed. "But if you lose, I'll have your souls. Deal?" Cuphead, blinded by easy riches, nodded and grabbed the dice for a throw. "Good gosh, Cuphead, no!" cried Mugman, for he understood the danger. But it was too late. "Snake eyes!" laughed the devil while slamming the floor. "You lose!" The brothers trembled in fear as he loomed over them. "Now, about those souls." The brothers pleaded for their very lives. There must be another way to repay you," Mugman stammered. "Yes, but please, mister," Cuphead added. "Perhaps there is," the devil snickered, pulling out a parchment. "I have here a list of my runaway debtors. Collect their souls for me, and I just might pardon you two mugs." "Now get going," the devil roared, kicking the boys out most rudely. "You have till midnight tomorrow to collect every one of those souls. Otherwise, I'll be the one collecting yours." Cuphead and Mugman were terribly frightened and ran away as fast as they could. "Come on, Mug," panted Cuphead. "We have to find the Elder Kettle. You'll know what to do." And Dancing Hourglass, because 1930s. I don't know why I'm not using my webcam for this. What a fine pickle you boys have gotten yourselves into. I know you don't want to be pawns of the devil, but if you refuse, I can't bear to imagine your fates. You must play along for now, collect those contracts, and you'd best be ready for some nasty business. Your debtor friends won't be very friendly once you confront them. In fact, I expect they'll transform into terrible beasts. It's like you know the future or something. That's kind of creepy. Take this potion so they won't hang out to dry. It'll give you the most remarkable magical abilities, like the ability to become dynamite heady and throw your head around, apparently. Now go to my writing desk and use the mystical inkwell there. You need to prepare yourself for a scrap. Heh, inkwell, scrap piece of paper, get it? Ooh, tutorial. Yes, please, guys. Just in case. Hold down to crouch. Jump. Tap for short, hold for high. Why the dash? Why to dash? There we go. I know that fires. Whee! Down an A to descend. Extra shoot. Right bumper. Okay, this is our right bumper. Stay in place. Parry slap. Press jump while airborne to nullify or interact with pink objects. It also builds a super meter. Okay. Try and do something here. Okay. Resurrect. Revive your dead pal with a well-timed parry on the ghost. Two-player mode only. There we go. Yes, move. An upgraded attack that requires one super meter card. Coin. Collect coins per item from the shop. Exit. Leave the area. I mean, it didn't tell me what the exit did, so I just assumed you leave the area. And more dancing hourglass. Okay, so we can go ahead and exit here. More dancing hourglass. It's so entertaining. Okay. Hang on, that was, I guess, why I can... Okay, so I got my shots here. Contract list. Okay. Hi there. Hey, fellas. Look like you're in for it now, eh? Oh, we're in Canada. Well, I used to be the same way. Always getting into trouble. Running, jumping, shooting. But now I prefer just strolling around and going to the pictures. Hey, let me give you a hand. Take this. It's a secret to everybody. There's a shop there. I got a door down here. The Root Bag. Botanic Picnic. So, difficult selection. I'm going to stick to regular. I'm going to regret it, I'm sure, but I like playing these on normal difficulty, or as close to normal. Alright. I've heard that a lot of these are pretty much boss battles, so to speak. Okay, that. I figured. Parry, it's a pink object. There we go. Aha, there we go. Okay, I never heard of the onion crying, but again. 1930s, what are you gonna do? Homing carrots. Ah! Now this is a oh man, I was almost to the end too. This match will get red hot. Now. Alright. See if I can build my courage again. It's gonna be a little tough to do here. That is hard to get that parry. I can't see my... Ah, I should have waited on that, but... The onion didn't seem too bad, really. Just waiting for the water to fall and dodging it. Oh, I just realized there's a pink one there, too. Alright, so, I got all five. Let's do this, then. Ah! Well, this thing has a lot of HP. Since I know this is what a lot of the game is pretty much like these boss fights of sorts. time now for that. A little wait and get another card there. Alright, well, I'm doing a little better. I've actually got 2 HP going into the carrot. Alright. That wasn't too bad. I kind of think the carrot is a little easier than the onion for the simple reason that it's not easier to see where the carrots are coming from. You just gotta focus more on them than anything else. Almost got all gold if I didn't lose that first HP trying to parry the snake, but yeah, I like a challenge. Soul Contract the Root Pack. Soul Contract the Root Pack. I do want to go up to the shop, though, and see what's in here. Pork Rinds Emporium. Guess food. Alright, so we got Chaser. EX Chaos Orbit. Long range with below average damage. No aiming required. Adds an extra hit point, but lightly weakens your attack power. Short range, but great damage if you can keep close to your targets. And smoke bomb. You will not take damage during a dash, a great defensive maneuver. And roundabout. Great coverage with average damage, aim backward for maximum range. Wow. Kind of makes sense in a way that they all have some sort of, like, weakness to them. So long range, but below average damage. You get an additional heart, or additional hit point, but your attack power goes down. Short range, great damage. That just won't take damage during a dash. And great coverage, aim backwards, maximum range. Right now, I kind of like having the extra hit point. Ha! Pea Sugar. The first parry move is automatic, all you need to do is jump. Well, that's interesting. Yeah, right now I'll take the extra hit point. I will take the slight decrease in damage. You guys to equip those new purchases if you want to use them. Look at your equip card, you bums. Which is why. Okay, so it's a charm. Okay, so it's not permanent. That's interesting. Okay, so I can choose my shots there if I wish, but I've only got the one right now. That's the pea shooter. Okay. Alright, so going to where you are. I'll be a monkey's uncle if I'm putting my moolah in the bank. For all I know, the devil probably controls that place too. They'll never get a hold of my gold if I spread it all around. And if some Joe happens to find a coin or two, good for him. That's what I say. Well, sure. Ruby and Croak's Clip Joint Calamity. Okay.
A great slam and then some. Now go!
That's the, shot there. I mean the jump. Crap. Oh, now they're going towards sides on me. Ah, okay, this might be a little tough. Closing quite to the third phase.
This match will get red hot. It's on!
Let's go to retry. I want to see if I can at least parry that first shot he throws out. Ah, now just stand right there. Perfect. Well, I'm terrible parrying shots. That was just stupid. Hey, that was really stupid.
A brawl is surely brewing. Here goes.
Oh. Starting off with this attack. Did not know you could actually do that. He could actually do that. I don't know what they attack they do after that because I'm not used to lasting this long. Hey, just keep this back up. Okay, whoa. That was stupid. Wow. Holy, that's gonna be tough.
Good day for a swell battle. Here goes.
At least getting a little better at the second phase. That seems a lot easier to hit. Okay, it doesn't matter where I hit it. I just gotta hit it. Ow. Oh, and that killed it too. Possibly. I can't tell if that actually was going to kill it or not, but still. I mean, sure, I was still a bit way off for that, but...
You're up.
I couldn't quite get that one. That was just a bad jump on my part. These at least seem to alternate every few shots. As easy as these seem to be the dodge, I kind of want to hold off on using my special shots on this. Oh crap, I don't want him throwing downwards. I don't want to do that. I didn't realize I was actually throwing him downwards. Ah. I actually survived it. My rating's gonna suck for that, but I survived it. Okay, I got my three parries. I used my super. Got my super meter up. That'd be plus, not as bad as I thought it was gonna be.
I'm Mr. King Dice, I'm the gamest in the land. I never play nice, I'm the devil's right-hand man.